What's going on, guys? Crypto Renegade again here for you. And in today's video, we are going to be doing another hardware wallet comparison video. On my left, we're going to be looking at the brand new Kivo hardware wallet that just released not too long ago. And on my right, we have the Elipal Titan, one that I have recommended and personally use most frequently. We're gonna dive in here. And before I jump into the content, I just wanna remind everyone again, I know I've probably beaten it with the dead horse, but I created a brand new in-depth ebook, 7 Best Ways to Secure Your Crypto, updated for 2021. It's in the description and it's gonna be pinned in the comments. So check that out, it's 100% free. All right, so let's dive in here. I like doing these hardware wallet comparison videos because what this allows people to do is decide, you know, when making a choice between a hardware wallet. And I'll link above if you're brand new to crypto and hardware wallets in general to get an understanding of why it's important to have one and use one frequently. But ultimately, I wanted to do a comparison of this brand new Kivo hardware wallet and the Elipal Titan here on my right. Now, we're gonna cover 3 categories, and these 3 categories are the ones that I typically look at when I am looking to buy a hardware wallet. Number 1, we're gonna look at the design, security, and form factor of each device, as well as the usability. Number 2, we're gonna look at coin support, what specific coins are supported, as well as any unique ones that you're not gonna find on other hardware wallets. And then finally, we're gonna end on the price, and ultimately, if I had to pick one, which one of these I would choose. So let me go ahead and start here with the Kivo hardware wallet. On this device here, it's brand new. This is a biometric hardware wallet, meaning it's authenticated with your thumbprint, as you can see here. And this one is brand new. I've only been using it, to be honest, for a few days, but I've been sending and receiving transactions and testing out its overall usability. The device here is utilizing a USB-C, so this is not air-gapped, meaning that you do have to manage your portfolio to send and receive and manage your portfolio using a desktop app, similar like you would with the Trezor Suite or the Ledger Live app. Just be aware that this is not a wireless device. This does require a desktop application in order to manage your portfolio. However, this is a premium and a high-end device, so it is gonna be more expensive than the Elipal Titan here on my right, and we'll touch on that in a second. But this is a beautiful, well-done, high-quality device. It's stainless steel, or what appears to be brushed stainless steel. It feels very durable, very sturdy. As you can see, there's a USB-C port here for plugging it in and charging with a very nice braided cable. And then on my right here, this is known as the Carbon Key. And what's unique about the security and form factor here is this is a magnetic device, and this is a seedless recovery seed, meaning that you don't have to write down on your piece of paper a 12 to 24 word recovery seed backup. Everything is generated on this device here so that you don't have to mess with it, and you can use this and connect it every time you want to send and receive a transaction. Another benefit to this device here is not only does it also have a beautiful large touchscreen here, but it does allow you to have multi-factor or multiple factors to sign a transaction, similar to multi-sig or multi-signature. What that basically means is you need to have 3 out of 4 components in order to sign or send any crypto. So just to break this down, number 1, the device itself here is factor number 1. You need this obviously in order to sign and send and receive. Number 2 is a PIN code. This is a 4-to-8 digit code that you set on the device, and you will need to enter that when you're signing and sending a transaction. The other one here is this fingerprint authenticator. Obviously, that's unique to you with your thumbprint, and you can also program multiple people on the thumbprint as well, so you can have multiple people share the device. And then 4th here is the carbon key. And you only need 3 out of the 4 to send and receive transactions. Which is very unique, and it's also very secure. So I do like that about this particular device. Now, this also is very unique that it also offers a beneficiary service. So what that means here is that it's partnered with Iron Mountain. It's an optional service that allows you to basically send in this carbon key to a custodial service, and it's secure in a bank vault. And basically the purpose of this is if you pass away or become incapacitated, this will allow you to pass your crypto on to a loved one that you designate, and they can restore your crypto. Because it is honestly a problem that has yet to be tackled with crypto, is what happens if you lose your crypto or the owner of it dies and they don't tell you your password or recovery seed. And this is just a very eloquent way to actually pass this on, and it's an optional monthly subscription service if that's something that you want to do and that is a concern to you. So this is the first and only hardware wallet that does that. So I like that as an option. The other thing here is people are wondering, well, what happens to my recovery seed if I lose the device or I lose the carbon key? How do I restore the crypto if there's no recovery seed? After digging around in the settings here, I did see that there is a seed phrase in this option here that will display only on the device. You have to plug it in obviously to the web application and authenticate it, but it will generate you a 24-word recovery seed phrase on the screen in the event that you need to write it down. It's not recommended, but it is an option and it's very easy to use. So this is the sort of design security form factor. I do like that this is premium and high end. I sort of don't necessarily like that there isn't a mobile option yet or Bluetooth or anything like that where I can use it directly on my smartphone. But overall, my experience in the couple of days that I've really rigorously tested this and used it, it's a very high quality and it's a very good device. Now, this here is the Elipal Titan. I'll do a quick recap on this. The key features on this one, if you've seen any of my other videos, this is right now my number one go-to hardware wallet. As you can see, it's very robust, it's very secure. This is portless, so there's no ports. It just has a magnetic puck for allowing you to charge and to upgrade firmware here. It's a full 4-inch touchscreen display here, and you can set a password and a pattern, and then you can sign and send and receive with an iOS or a Android application for your phone. And this is 100% air gapped, so it is secure. There's no USB, there's no Bluetooth, there's no NFC, there's no Wi-Fi. Everything is transmitted securely through the QR code on the camera right here. And it also generates QR codes on the screen here as well, so that if you have a smartphone that you're sending your crypto from, you can send it directly to this device with no connection needed, literally just a camera. And that's very convenient and it's very secure. And this is primarily intended for the mobile user. So you can take this with you on the go. You don't need any connection. You don't need any desktop apps, computers, anything else as well. So that's one of the primary reasons that I like this. In addition to that, this also allows staking on certain coins such as DOT, such as XTZ, such as KSM, just to name a few off the top of my head that you can stake on this device. And it has a very well-managed iOS and Android app for managing your portfolio and everything in between. The overall form factor, security, and design, this is more gonna be a mobile user, someone that wants the convenience in setting that up on the go. And this is gonna be for someone that wants to manage your portfolio on a desktop, a very clean and user-friendly interface, much like the Trezor Suite, much like the Ledger Live app. So let's jump into the second factor here. On the Elipal Titan and the Kivo One, in terms of coin support, I'm gonna start here with the Kivo. Now, just to reiterate, this is a brand new device, and most new hardware wallet providers, when they launch a device, the full coin support stack is not readily available at launch. It takes time to roll that out. As someone that's worked on a hardware wallet myself, I understand it's very computer intensive, cost intensive to add and support new coins, not to mention getting community support and so on. So this is something that will roll out and expand over time, no matter which hardware wallet provider you want to use. And just to reiterate here, this particular device has very limited, at the moment, at launch, coin support, meaning this device is only gonna support 4 coins as of shooting this video. And you can always check the links down and below in the description for both of these devices to give you the most up-to-date discounts and the most up-to-date accurate information in terms of coin support and things of that nature. So make sure to check that out if you're interested, because there are usually discounts attached to my link. At any rate, going back to the coin support, this will support Bitcoin, which includes SegWit as well. So legacy Bitcoin, SegWit, SegWit, BEC32. And if you're unfamiliar with those, not a big deal. It's just certain preferences of the Bitcoin network. Second is going to be Bitcoin Cash. Third is going to be Bitcoin SV. And fourth is going to be Ethereum. As of right now, those are the only coins that are supported. They're going to be rolling out and expanding ERC20 tokens. They're going to be expanding a lot of different coin support as well. So just be advised that right now, this will only support those particular coins. To some people, they may only want to hold Bitcoin and Ethereum. They may not want to have several altcoins, at which point this is good to go right away. So that's the coin support on Kivo. Just be aware of that right now, limited to 4 and some Bitcoin variations. Now on the Elipal Titan, this one does have several more coins and tokens, has all the Tron TRC10 and TRC20 tokens, has all the EOS tokens as well. And then of course it has your basic Bitcoin, Ethereum. This also holds all your ERC20 tokens, ADA to name a few, XTZ, Polkadot, and there's a lot more. Check the link in the description to see if your specific coin is going to be supported. And just wanted to reiterate that this does have an option for multiple coins. So DGB, XRP, Litecoin, Ethereum Classic, Bitcoin Cash, just to show you a few: Decree, Grossel Coin, Zcoin, EOS, BNB, ADA, BSV. So this is gonna hold all the same coins as this, but this one will hold more. This one also holds Dogecoin, which is pumping like crazy right now. So that's very interesting as well. So just wanted to kind of reiterate that these have a very different array of coin support now, and you just want to be aware of that when you're deciding which of these wallets to go to. So let's jump on the third and final category here, which is price, and then ultimately which one I would choose. As I mentioned, the Kivo Model 1 is a premium device, meaning it's higher quality. It's going to have better sort of different security features, like this one is multi-factor, multi-sig, whereas this one is not, although it is air-gapped. But to your point, the price on this one is $299 for the Model 1. And if you want the upgraded Founders Edition, which basically is just upgraded carry case and mount and things of that nature, that's $399 US. Again, those are the standard prices. Check the links in the description for any current discounts and bonuses that are going on at the moment. The Elipal Titan, the standard full price on this device here, is $179. There's typically sales going on with this, so it could be much lower. Again, check the links in the description. You know, obviously this one is more than $100 cheaper, and it offers some unique features that this device doesn't. Again, these are both very good, and this one I've been using for almost 2 years now, and this is sort of my number one go-to for the moment. And the Kivo has only been out recently, so I've only been playing around with it. And sort of price comparison, you can see there's a pretty big disparity there. Now, which one of these would I choose? Personally, if I could only choose one and I was in the market for a hardware wallet, I would say for my personal preference and my personal taste, I would still have to go with the Elipal Titan, mainly because it has more altcoins that I wanna hold offline and I wanna store, as well as staking. Now, I fully anticipate that Kivo is going to allow coin staking and more coin support over time, and I have zero doubts about that, and I'd be much more inclined to compare these two once it has that option. I personally also like the air-gapped and the mobile support not being tethered to a computer, so that's another reason that I personally like to use this. It really just comes down to how do you like to interact with the device, meaning do you like plugging it in and managing it on your computer with a bigger application, or do you want sort of like a small air-gapped cell phone type form factor like this where it's completely mobile and you can use it on the go, and then ultimately which is more important for you in terms of managing your portfolio. So I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up here. If you have any questions or comments or concerns, leave them in the comment section below. And then let me know if this over the shoulder sort of video type is better for you when I'm comparing hardware wallets. Let me know if this is something that you want me to change, sort of the format of filming. I know a couple of years ago I was doing these in my kitchen when I was brand new to YouTube and I didn't know what the hell I was doing. I thought this one would be better so you could see the device is more close up and it would be a little bit easier to see and a little bit easier to read. Go ahead and please comment and let me know if you want me to continue making my comparison hardware wallet videos in this sort of over the shoulder format. All right, I'll go ahead and wrap this up here. And then in my top right corner right now, go ahead and click on my full unboxing review on the Kivo hardware wallet since it's brand new. And I'll sort of give a deeper dive into this particular wallet. See you guys in that video. Crypto Renegade out.